The only people who don't want to disclose the truth are people with something to hide.
That Bin Laden had died of Marfan's disease. You can only live a few years with that. He had total kidney failure. Nobody lives longer than 6 years, even on dialysis. And it came out in CBS News that he indeed was at the American hospital being visited and treated by U.S. doctors and the CIA months before 9/11. And we'll play a short clip of that CBS newscast with Dan Rather for you.
CBS News has been told that the night before the September 11th terrorist attack, Osama bin Laden was in Pakistan. He was getting medical treatment with the support of the very military that days later pledged its backing for the U.S. war on terror in Afghanistan. Pakistan intelligence sources tell CBS News that bin Laden was spirited into this military hospital in Rawalpindi for kidney dialysis treatment.
So we know bin Laden died a long time ago. And then I interviewed, off record, two high-level Bush administration people that blew the whistle.
Or a month from now, or a year from now. But we're going to get him.
Dead or alive.
The United States has conducted an operation that killed Osama bin Laden, the leader of Al-Qaeda. And a terrorist who's responsible for the murder of thousands.
Of WND.com is reporting that Barack Obama has announced through his attorney, Jablonski, that he, Barack Obama, will boycott the hearings scheduled for today. Jablonski, Obama's lawyer, told Georgia Secretary of State Brian Kemp in a letter that, quote, serious problems have developed in the hearings. Jablonski said, quote, at issue in these hearings are challenges that allege that President Obama is not eligible to hold or run for re-election to his office on the now wholly discredited theory that he does not meet the citizenship requirements, end quote. However, Secretary of State Kemp said the case referral was, quote, in keeping with Georgia law. Kemp said this in a letter to Jablonski. To the extent a request to withdraw the case referral is procedurally available, Kemp said, I do not believe such a request would be judicious, given the hearing is set for tomorrow morning, Kemp continued. I expect the administrative law judge to report his findings to me after his full consideration of the evidence and law. Upon receipt of the report, I will fully and fairly review the entire record and initial decision of the administrative law judge. Secretary of State Kemp went on to say, if you and your client choose to suspend your participation in the proceedings, please understand that you do so at your own peril, end quote. So after the judge told Obama that the subpoena that was issued was perfectly valid and that he had to appear in court on January 26th and he had to bring with him all of the documents that were demanded by the court, Obama decided to go behind the back of the judge and send the complaint about this case to the Secretary of State, and now he's asking the Secretary of State to take the trial away from the judge. Now, folks, I got to ask you, does this even begin to look like the behavior of an innocent person? An innocent person would have come to the court, showed all of the valid documents with the embossed seals, which are all verifiable. He would have either been there himself or at the very least sent his attorney with all of the documents, rather than looking for every maneuver possible to go behind the back of the judge to stop the entire trial. Jablonski went on to write in his protestation, quote, it is well established that there is no legitimate issue here, a conclusion validated time and again by courts around the country. The state of Hawaii produced official records documenting birth there. The president made documents available to the general public by placing them on his website, he wrote. All I can say to that is Jablonski is telling one lie or fabrication or misunderstanding after another.
Hello, YouTube. Well, I'm making that little first clip there with Alex Jones, and then I put this thing in here about the Georgia birth certificate thing, just to show you how far-fetched all the lies that they're telling you. And Alex is telling you the video there. It's on my blog. This will be on the blog with the same thing. You need to go watch the whole thing. And the thing about the birth certificate, I got both of those all over the blog. I mean, I'm making this video just to, you know, to help y'all out with all this. This is it's gone too far, folks. You got to wake up. I mean, we keep repeating the same thing over and over again, and it's starting to sink in, but it needs to sink in just a little bit faster to the folks that aren't getting it. Pass it around, the friends, pass it to one friend. Get the information out somehow, people. This stuff really needs to go. I'm going to post the first part of this video again, just so you can actually hear what they actually tell you, and then Obama telling you that he just killed him. So pay attention to it, folks. I mean, what else is there? I mean, you either do or you don't, and you're gonna lose all your freedoms one way or the other. If you keep going the way you're going now, you're gonna lose them. We've already lost a bunch, and if it keeps going, we're gonna lose them all. So, you know, check it out, watch it, see what you think. Much love, heads up.
That Bin Laden had died of Marfan's disease. You can only live a few years with that. He had total kidney failure. Nobody lives longer than 6 years, even on dialysis. And it came out in CBS News that he indeed was at the American hospital being visited and treated by U.S. doctors and the CIA months before 9/11. We'll play a short clip of that CBS newscast with Dan Rather for you.
CBS News has been told that the night before the September 11th terrorist attack, Osama bin Laden was in Pakistan. He was getting medical treatment with the support of the very military that days later pledged its backing for the U.S. war on terror in Afghanistan. Pakistan intelligence sources tell CBS News that bin Laden was spirited into this military hospital in Rawalpindi for kidney dialysis treatment.
So we know bin Laden died a long time ago. And then I interviewed, off record, two high-level Bush administration people that blew the whistle.
Or a month from now, or a year from now. But we're going to get him.
Dead or alive.
The United States has conducted an operation that killed Osama bin Laden, the leader of Al-Qaeda. And a terrorist is responsible for the murder of thousands.